Sheikh Mohammed, would you agree that there are two approaches to human rights, the Western and the Islamic?
Ferris, I would like to say hello, everybody, and Allah grant me the wisdom to know the difference and give me the power I can change what I can change and the serenity to accept what I cannot change. I would like to correct. Islam is innocent from any accusation for abusing human rights. And there is some misunderstanding and misleading is going along with this interpretation. I would like to tell my friends here, they have to know every word in the Quran, in the Mecca verses, which is the early verses, which is we believe as a Muslim, was driven from the New Testament. It was talking about all humanity and all people are equal. And there is no difference between everybody. All people are equal. But later on, there is Old Testament, which is this was derived from the Old Testament, as you call it in your Bible, the Old Testament. We call it the Old Testament in the Holy Quran, which is the verses of Medina. It was derived from the Old Testament. These verses, yes, is discriminate. These verses, yes, is put. It allow killing, allow fighting, man have four wives, and a lot of things, you know. But these verses, it was in the Old Testament too. The same Old Testament you have as Christian, you have all these things. The discrimination of women, of the killing, of the fighting, of the divorce, of the circumcision, of, you know, belief for worshiping. But we believe as a Muslim, as high understanding Muslim, this verses was obligate. Because this verses, it was for a certain time. It comes for a certain time and it used in a suitable time and it used in a good way. Even when Prophet Muhammad used the sword, he used it like the doctor used the knife to heal you and to cure you. If you come up and try even to emphasize, I justify why the Muslim use things, and always I see people here talk about the Old Testament and this misunderstanding. So I see now all Muslims around the world are uprising. Uprising against what? Against this discrimination, because they see their whole Quran full of equal right of women, free for everybody, free speech, democracy, and everything. But still people, they use Old Testament of the Quran. So that is really ridiculous. But that is, I want you to make difference between politics and religion. So Islam and Quran is a very good. It is wonderful. But don't judge and don't blame Quran or Islam. Blame the ruler, the government. Because these people really are not practicing Islam. They use Islam as Mr. Walid Faris, and really I will encourage him and I will thank him for talking about the discrimination and the fighting in Sudan. And I agree with him, and I would like to add for him, even I was candidate president of Sudan, the government, and I have seen by my own eyes the rigged election, the stolen election, and the interference of the government, and he claimed he was a Muslim and his government is a Muslim country. So I would like you to understand the politics, to try to make difference between the politics and Islam. So those politics around the world here, all the Islamic world, actually they are using the Old Testament of the Holy Quran. They don't want to do reform. But if you go to the majority of Muslim, the most Sufi and intellectual, they have this meaning. They practice it in their way, because we use equal. We are here, and even I believe, you know, all the human rights now in the United Nations, it was really like somebody has read the Quran, read the Mecca verses, and put the United Nations rules, which was in 1948, but the Quran in a long time ago. And I believe all religion come for human rights. You know, even if you come to, but if you try to bring up What's happening in the 7th century? Today, yeah, it looks shame. It looks bad. It looks disgusting. But that is not the religion. You have to know the difference. That is, you have to know why Allah has given obligation. Mm-hmm. Why Allah said, "Man istakh min aya wa nusya anati bi khayrin minha aw mithliha lam ta'lamana Allah ala kulli shay'in qadir." You have to understand why Allah said we abrogate verses. If we abrogate verses or we store it for some times, we bring a better one or the similar one or the same one. So, but because the dictatorship of Muslim world, they don't give the freedom like we have now in America. They don't give it. So everybody try to talk, he will be hung or killed or imprisoned. So the fear of to talk is the I myself. I have a lot of trouble and problem because when I was in election on my candidates, I was talk about the reform, the revolution of thought. The people, they try to understand Islam in a better way. We have everything in our Islam, in our religion. So I see there is no problem actually with the United Nations rules and about also the Islamic, if you understanding in a right way. But if you continue to talk about the Old Testament of the Quran, the difference between men and women in that time, and you're talking about, you know, Prophet Muhammad married a little girl, and all this is nonsense. That is, talk about that time. That is for that time. If you want to bring up that, we can bring up a lot of things from the Old Testament in the Holy Book, in the Book of Abraham, in the Talmud, in the Torah, and we bring it up. But it is not bad for that time. But actually, if you bring it nowadays in America, it is sound, as I mentioned earlier, it was not real. So Islam was talk about to be united. Actually, the Western are practicing these verses. They are united. America, United States of America, Europe. If you come about Islam, talk about cleanliness next to godness.
Okay, but Sheikh Mohammed, I have to cut you off because I want to turn it to Robert. He's smiling, and I know he has a lot to respond to. But can I ask you something? You say that you push for reform in Sudan. In order for reform to happen, you have to acknowledge that there's something wrong. But what you have said is that there's nothing wrong with Islam, and it's just misinterpreted. So what would you reform if there's nothing wrong with Islam to begin with?
Actually, what I reform is people are equal. Women are equal. They have the same, and Allah said that in the Quran, وَلَهُنَّ مِثْلَ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ.